Okay, in doing that, take out the excess. Right, now it's just a matter of setting the trap. Always remember to have your pan or the plate and the lazy jaw to the open side of your set. The trap is designed to go off with the plate going down. If you had it that way and the dog treads there, he's never going to set it off. So always remember to have your trap with the lazy jaw and the plate going down set out. Okay. Now, again, we've got the trap open. We bed it in. Right, we got him bed in. We're happy with that. It's not going to rock. As you can see, once we bed that in, it's going to sit there. All right, spring goes in. Now, I use snow grass, which I get locally on the edge of the banks. It's just the underside that's dead of the snow grass. It's a fine little mat. You pull some out. And what you do, you sort of, like the old blokes that used to roll the cigarette, don't roll it too tight, just have it reasonably loose. And what that does, it fills this gap up here, stops any dirt, stone going in underneath the plate to stop the plate from going off. The plate has got to go down for that track to activate. So what we do, nice and carefully, in there, put the snow grass in like that. So what that is, that stops any of this dirt here, fines, there, stop from going under the plate. I've got to now go right round that there, because it can impede the trap from the sides. So a little bit more grass. Open it up a bit so it's not too thick. And again, we put it where the gaps are. Try and keep as tight as you can so it's not sticking out too far, because that will then act as a wedge. So nice and carefully like that, a little bit more. So let's open him up a bit so he's not too thick. In again, nice and gentle. A little bit more. Some blokes use brown paper, greaseproof paper. I personally like the snow grass. So there's the trap ready now to be covered. The reason I use the snow grass, if the wind or the rain blows the dirt off, then the dog has got something to look at. The wind and that blows a portion of that dirt off, then it's natural. It still looks the same as that, because the grass will come up through it, but it's doing its job. Okay, the next thing I do is get me sieve. The reason I use the sieve is to take the rocks out, because the rocks can hold the jaws apart. If that was my jaws and a rock went in there, it's held apart, therefore I'm not getting full pressure on the dog. So you use the sieve to take the rock and everything else out that's going to hold your jaws. Right, just place the sieve over there nice and gentle. And what I do, I just go around the edges of the trap to start with. I don't cover the full trap. I go around the edges of the trap to bed it in with the jaws. So right up, on with the sieve. We just go around the edges. Of the dirt we've reclaimed. Okay, you can see the rock that I've got in there. That would impede the trap. Now you can see I've got dirt around the trap. So very gently, what I do now is bed my trap in. Right, round I go, like such. And what that's doing is holding that trap into the ground. And if you don't do that, then, like I said, you get the rocking motion, and if the dog treads here, see, I can press that there now and that trap's not moving. I can press that there, that trap's not moving. If that was to rock, he would tread there. He maybe put his second paw there. But if he treads there and that trap tips, kicks it off, you've created what you call a trap shy dog. So that is very important. As much as where how you put it there, is to bed that trap. And again, like I say, if you're not confident, then by all means, you know, grab someone that knows what they're doing. Righto, so I've got that bedded. What I'll do, I'll use a little stick just to bring this across. The old rabbit trap used to put your finger in underneath. With these, it's just as easy if you do a gentle and don't press down. It's just bringing across like that. Now, I'll just show what I mean if the wind was to blow. You can see the grass comes up. It doesn't matter. It still looks natural. If that was paper, then you would see paper, a shiny surface, and they don't grow old being stupid. You've got to have everything going for you. So I'll put the dirt on like that, brush it out a little bit more. Try not to have too much dirt over your trap because the weight of it, if it rains, and in my case here, snow, it will set your trap off because of the weight it gets with the moisture. So what we do, we just slightly brush that out like that. Right. Okay. Excess dirt here, we'll cover our drag with. A little bit up there for the spring. Chain. And then what we do then is just a little bit of a leaf litter. Sprinkle over from around here. Try not to make too much disturbance. And then another trick that I use what they call a trip stick. If the dog stands back here, I need to make something there to make him take that extra tread. If he treads on a stick, it's going to hurt his paw. So what I do, say like this for instance, this little stick like that, that's all it takes. You find your outside jaw, like that there, there's my jaw. You can see. So what I do now is place this stick along there. Bed it in. As you can see, the jaw is still there. Right, so I've just bedded it out of the road of the workings of the jaw and set the stick like that. So if that dog comes now and sits there and he's just too far to reach, he'll make that extra effort. He won't tread there, so therefore he's got to tread there to get at what he wants to smell. So that's called a trip stick. And that just brings in that extra step. All right, few little trigs here to go over, not too much, because again, you will impede and make sure that there's no twigs or rocks or whatever, or in this case around here, little gum nuts. A simple little gum nut could act as a stone, again, keep the jaws open. So just as simple as that, right? Okay.